Hello and welcome back to my channel. As you can see by the title of today's video, I'm going to be showing you this really quick and super easy natural hairstyle that looks like crochet, but it's braidless. You don't need a crochet hook. All you need is like a pack of Marley hair, or you can use the hair that I'm going to show you, a couple of bobby pins and some ponytail holders. So let's get right into it and do it. All right, so first off, I want to say that I am doing a full tutorial on this hairstyle because I posted this on Instagram Reels, and I also posted it on TikTok, and I've had a lot of questions on how I did the back, and I will put the hairstyle somewhere on the video so that you can see what I mean. So I'm going to make sure that I go slow and I talk you through it so that you can understand. And a quick disclaimer, this hairstyle is not for everyone, and I say that because it's a bobby pin hairstyle, and a lot of people are not comfortable with just wearing bobby pins, you know, to secure their hair. But I wore this style earlier today, and it was windy as hell in my city, and it was just fine. Because of the way I bobby pinned it, I didn't have any problems, and when the hair lifted, you couldn't see my braid, so it was perfect. So make sure that you just follow the directions and you will be all right. Oh, and all of the products I use will be down below in the description box, so make sure you check that out. All right, so the hair I'm gonna be using is the Outre Expression Twisted Up Springy Afro Twist in the length 16 inches, and I got this in a color 1B. I actually tried to record this video yesterday, and it was such a fail because I had a 1 and it was very noticeable with like what I was trying to do. So I had to get the right hair, and here we are today. So if you want to do the style in the way that I'm doing it, I would suggest you get 2 packs of these of this hair. And I got this from my local beauty supply store, and it was $6.99 a pack. I know you can also get it online from places like Sam's Beauty, Sister Wigs, Wig Types, but if you can find it in your local beauty supply, I suggest you go with that because it's probably going to be a lot cheaper, and of course it's faster because it's right there. When I looked for this hair online, it was sold out, and I got one on Amazon, but it was probably like $13 or $14 for one of these. So just keep that in mind. All right, so this is what the hair looks like out the pack. And it is very important that you keep the hair separated just as is, because what we're gonna do is take each of these bundles of hair and we're gonna make a ponytail with it. So this step is very important. And I'm about to show you how I make my ponytail, since that's also something that a lot of you guys had trouble with. So you see, I just cut the little twist tie that was on the end of it. I'm not gonna separate this hair or fluff it or do anything to it. I'm gonna leave it as is and fold it in half. And there is already a rubber band on it. If you want, you can use a black one or like a hair tie, but I find that it's easier to hide this than it is to hide a hair tie. So what you're gonna do is take the rubber band and stretch it out underneath the hair. And you're gonna end up with 2 loops. And you're going to take this one, the first loop, and put it underneath the second and pull it. And there you have it. Now, you can lightly separate the hair and fluff it out. Lightly. And see how pretty that looks? So do not separate the curls at this step. Like I said, lightly pull them apart because they were stuck, but don't separate the curls just yet. You're gonna wait. All right, so I've just made 3 ponytails, and the easiest way to separate them without pulling them is to just shake it out, to shake the curls loose. And It literally makes it look so much better and it helps. And also try to make sure that you put the rubber band as close to the center as possible so that their hair will be an even length, because otherwise you're gonna end up like me with this side longer than this side. But you know, once it's done, it's done. So just be mindful. All right, so I just took my scarf off. I already laid, you know, my little baby hairs or whatever. So as you can see, I already have my hair sectioned off just because it's easier for me to part my hair and like prep it off camera because I can't really see. And right now I don't have a mirror or anywhere to prop it so that I can see myself. So what I did is I sectioned off my hair from ear to ear and I slicked this up into a little, you know, bun. And then the back of my hair is braided. No cornrows. I do know how to cornrow, but I was feeling lazy. And like I said, I wanted this to be easy and something that anyone can do. And so I just made it braidless. So what you're gonna wanna do is pin these braids down in the back. So I'm about to show you that. All right, so here comes the best part, putting in the back. So I have my three ponytails, and like I said, I'm gonna try to go as slow for you as possible, but it's really simple. So what you're gonna do is take these three and layer them, starting from the bottom, going all the way up to the top. And I might have to zoom in on this part just so that you can really see what I'm doing. So yeah. I'm trying to make sure that you guys get the gist. And if you still have any questions, then I'll be able to answer them, you know, as they come. So yeah. All right, so I'm about to turn around. And for this part, you are going to need a lot of bobby pins. So. When you take the hair, make sure that you find the part where the rubber band is and you hide it. This side of the ponytail is going to be facing my head. So it's going to be like this. Thank you. Okay. So since I'm at the top, I'm going to turn back around because I need to be able to see this one. Because more than likely, this is the part that people would actually see. Since it's layered, the other parts of your hair are covered up, but they're going to see this. So what you're gonna do is put this ponytail as close to your part as possible. Like, see how it's coming up a little bit? That's what you want. So the most important part when securing these ponytails is to make sure that you're bobby pinning underneath the hair, not like this, but like this. So you see this side right here is really secure and this side is not. If the wind were to blow, it would blow all this up and we don't want that. But if it blows this, you're fine. Or if it blows this in the back, you're totally fine. So what I'm doing is finding the strand of hair that's at the bottom and bobby pinning underneath, right? And then let the hair that's on top fall like so. See this side, how secure this is versus this side? Oopsie. This side is not secure enough. And this top part is not secure at all. So I also see the difference in the length. So let's get that fixed. Okay, so let me just show you what it's looking like in the back right now. So a little tip is to kind of take some of the hair that's in this top section and make sure you're covering these parts. You want to make sure that you can't see any of your hair and that all of the rubber bands are hidden as well. So this is what it looks like right now. Now, one side definitely is like longer than the other, and it's probably because, like I said, how I put the ponytail holders or the rubber bands on the sections, it definitely affects how it's gonna come out. And in order to fix it, all I would have to do is like center these sections a little differently. But because I have my back turned to the camera, I can't see. But in the mirror, like, or facing the camera, I would be able to do this better and get this the lengths right. So just be mindful of that. If you don't put the ponytail holders in the middle, like, or as close to the middle, then it's going to be off, and then you're going to have to like even it out when you put them on, like putting them on your head. So yeah. All right, so I just used one full pack, which is all three bundles, to do the back of my hair. So now is where you would open that second pack. So I do have two packs of hair. However, I've used this hair for so many different styles that I have like a bunch of it laying around. So I had two extra bundles from an old pack that I had before. So I'm just gonna use those. And I'm about to show you two different ways that you can do the top. You can either do a bun, like a top knot bun, or you can do a ponytail. So first we're gonna do the bun. Okay, so I already have my hair in a ponytail. And for this one, like I said, you can always use a regular ponytail holder if you want to, since this one is not gonna be shown. You can always switch it with a ponytail holder. So what you're gonna do is take this rubber band and place it on your bun like so. You're going to take half of the hair and you're going to leave this half over here. Now, okay, that's what I want to do. So I'm going to cover the bun with the hair like this, and I'm going to twist it. And make sure you bobby pin that. You don't need a lot. One or two is fine. So now, in order to make it really big, you take the rest of the hair and you flip it like so. And that's how you get this really big bun or top knot, whatever you want to call it. So now just make sure that you bobby pin the bottom of the bun so it looks natural. So yes. Okay, so this is style number one. I have not separated the curls yet because I want to wait to show you me separating all of it once I do the ponytail on top. But this is super, super cute and it's really easy, and you can always dress it up if you want to and add some hair accessories like so. This is really, really cute. Oh my God, yes, I love it. And this is the style that I wore out earlier today, and I got so many compliments on it. I actually went to the hair store to get my right colored hair, and then these ladies were like, oh my God, like, what did you do to your hair? How did you get your hair like that? So I put them on game, you know. And then she said she was gonna do her daughter's hair similar to this, and I think it's super, super cute. So let's get into the ponytail hairstyle. All right, so I am using a different ponytail to do the top simply because I'm gonna use the first one to make my buns, and the curls are gonna be messy. I still want the curls to be intact. So I changed the rubber band to a ponytail holder because for this one, I needed to be black. So I'm going to place the ponytail holder on my bun and I'm going to double it for security. And now I'm going to move it backward like so, because I want to cover my bun. Okay, so remember what I said earlier about pinning underneath the hair? So you definitely want to do that in order to make this look as natural as possible, but while also covering that bun up. Okay, so this is what it's looking like, and let me show you the back. All right, so now we are about to separate these curls. Like I said, you can always leave it like this if this is the look that you're going for. I will say that if you leave the hair like this, you can get more wear out of it. Once you separate the curls, it starts looking a little wild. However, it looks super natural, but I don't know. I like it both ways. And you can wear this style for about 3 times using the same hair before it starts to get wild, like I said. If that doesn't bother you, then you can wear it more than 3 times. But if you're like me and you like your curls to be defined, then yeah, you're gonna want to change the hair. All right, so now for the good part. Let's separate these curls. I also see with my ponytail, it's like it's sideways too, like it's not even. This whole side is longer than this one, all because of how I put the ponytails. So what you're gonna do is take one and gently pull it apart. I'm not gonna separate them too much. Just once or twice is good enough for me. And I'm not separating from the top. I'm pulling the curls at the bottom. Thank you. So I am pulling this side just because it was bothering me that it's uneven. I don't like that. So now let's separate this ponytail. Wait. Okay, so now for the ponytail. The ponytail is already pretty fluffy, so I don't want to do too much. Okay, oh my God, I have oil all on my dress, but whatever. So this is the final product and I'm very happy with it. Very, very satisfied. So this is a lot of hair that I have on my head right now. And if you think that this is a bit too much for you, you can always reduce the size of the ponytails, but I didn't do that. Like every piece of hair they had in each ponytail, I used it. And I even kept like the same size for the hair on top, like for this top ponytail. And I think that I could have reduced it a little bit, you know, just so it wouldn't have been as full, because this is very thick at the top. But I mean, whatever, it's still cute in my opinion. Another thing I will say is I really had to bobby pin the hair like in the back right here so that it would cover this bun. So a suggestion of mine is if you want to do this ponytail hairstyle, like I did, for me, my hair is pretty thick and I have trouble getting my buns to be small. So if you can make your bun small, then you have nothing to worry about. But if your bun is thick and your hair is thick, then something you might want to try is before you do the ponytail to take like a couple pieces, not too much, but take maybe 3 or 4 pieces and put them in a ponytail like this. And then wrap this and make a bun around your bun, just so whenever you put the ponytail on, the hair still matches. That's what we want at the end of the day. We want the hair to match. We want people to think that this is your hair. So maybe in another video, I'll show you exactly what I mean, but I think my explanation was pretty straightforward. So I don't really have anything else to say, so I'm gonna say that, I'm sorry, I'm just gonna wrap it up and say, make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe, and also follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Shadi Nadadu, and I will see you in the next one. With the top down, let me look at your eye.